A short sale is a tactic that's used to avoid a foreclosure. Similar to deed in lieu of foreclosure in some regards, a short sale is when you contact the mortgage company and you tell them, I have somebody that wants to purchase my house and they won't pay the full amount on the house and I'm behind on my payments on the house, but I want your permission, mortgage company, to allow me to sell the house to this other person, this third party, so that way they can then purchase the house instead of me hanging on to it on a house that I can't afford the payments to. A lot of times the mortgage company will accept that, will allow you to do that at times. However, something that's very, very important, if the mortgage company allows a short sell, they allow, you have a house that you owe $150,000 on and you're able to sell that house for $125,000. That $25,000 difference, the amount that you have not covered when selling that house, you technically are responsible for that debt. The mortgage company technically could come after you and give you what's called a 1099 at the end of the year, saying that you're being taxed on that forgiven debt if they have forgiven it. They could choose not to forgive it and to sue you and to come after you for that $25,000 and say you still owe us that money and try to come and get it for you. A law that's in place right now at the making of the time of this video is there's a law in Congress that says that they will not tax you on debt forgiven on a short sale. That expires in 2012, and so whether or not it's renewed by Congress again, nobody really knows, but at least at the current time of this making of this video, they cannot tax you on debt that's forgiven on a short sale. However, the mortgage company could decide that they still want to come after you and try to sue you for that debt. So it's just something to be very aware of whenever you're doing a short sale. A lot of people think that a short sale is this great idea. It's a way to get rid of the house, and it can be some for some folks. But also just be aware of the consequences of a short sale, and also know it's going to be reflected on your credit report as well, and also does have a negative strike against you on your credit. So those are just a few little important things to know about a short sale. If you have any doubt, if you have any question, contact a bankruptcy attorney. Most offer a free consultation, and I would highly encourage you to at least speak with somebody and know what your different options are before just going through with the short sale without ever talking to somebody.